we have first an international referee, an excellent referee. I think 10 Olympic Games for men and fewer for women, and the World Championships, finals of the World Championship, an incredible number of occasions to referee. Probably the best, one of the best. Mr. Montoya, who also works with the national Qatar team, he's going to share with you his analysis of the 2016 Rio Olympic Games. He'll be talking about the 6-6 game when one player is sent off or excluded and therefore without any goalkeeper. You will be the second speaker? Yeah. First we'll listen to Ramon Gallego and then we'll listen to Manuel Montoya. Right. There will be no questions afterwards, but just a quick discussion after Mr. Canaille's session, who'll be talking about the new rules. Mr. Canaille will be talking about the new rules, and then after this, when we finished with the presentation from Mr. Canaille, we'll have a Q&A with Mr. Gallego, Mr. Montoya, and Mr. Canaille. So no Q&A at all after this session, but then it'll be food for thought, and we'll have the Q&A afterwards.
Thanks for the presentation. It happens many years ago, so I don't remember even. Okay, my idea is not to present you the new rules, but most of you know the new rules, just maybe to explain, to stop a little bit more in some details, and then to see some interesting clips. Okay, that's the idea. I have not also too much time. So, just a little bit about the history of the new rules, because there are many people around the world thinks that these new rules happen suddenly because a happy idea in one night. No, this is totally opposite idea. At least during more than 3 years, we have in IHF many meetings with many experts, especially also from the trainers or from the coaches part. And then, after so many discussions and many tests, we decide to implement these rules. First, we make a hard test in World Championship Junior and Youth. After the general positive feedback from these two World Championships, IHF decided to apply to use these new rules in just before the Olympic Games in Rio. The five topics that to be implemented, or we are implemented, you know this, injured player, passive play rule, last 30 second rules, blue card, and seven real field players, maybe the most controversial rules we will discuss later, to use a goalkeeper as a normal player. About the injured player, yes, about the reasons. First, we must sell handball, and we must make difference between our sport, handball, and the rest of the sports around the world, especially football. And then the idea is so clear, 60 minutes high tensions, 60 minutes high rhythm, 60 minutes high speed of handball, with the spectators seated and fully concentration and attention in our match, spectators on live or spectators on TV at home. This is the idea. As less interruptions as possible. And then this must be the difference, this will be the difference between our sport and the rest of sports, especially football and other sports like basket and so on. So. And then injured player is a big help for us and big success until this moment. What were the problems in the past? So many unnecessary medical care or treatment in the field, with the match stopped 1, 2, 3 or more minutes for absolutely nothing, or for tactical reasons. Second problem, so many fake Hollywood cheating actions, so many, especially in some continents, but also in Europe. so many fast throw ups, fast break, or counter attack destroyed because of nothing. Absolutely because of nothing. When we need really, it's true that the player needs some medical attention. Please, as fast, this is clear instruction for the referees, as faster as possible. This is not the moment for operation in the hospital. This is not the moment for surgery. No, this is the moment, okay, maybe some cold or something, or some ice, but immediately, because there's three attackers outside, go outside. As faster as possible, interruption. And then, of course, no more tactical breaking the high rate of the game. That's the idea. All together are leading a great, great success of this rule. Of course, don't forget TV broadcasting, especially in Olympic Games. How much costs 1 minute of TV? How much money costs? So much money. So we have not this money. So the idea, general idea for the referees, you know that normally the referees ask to the player if you need help. Do you need help? Clear, is yes or not. Or if really the referee thinks that this was so important injury, probably. Okay, immediately I stop the match and I call the doctors. But normally the referee asks to the player, do you need help or not? Tell me, in different languages, yes or not. And then I stop the match and I call the doctors. But the player knows that it happens later, three attacks outside. Okay? Okay, this is... but still, look the last words. The unfair, the unsportsmanlike conduct in the last 6 months totally reduced. No more, in general, no more Hollywood actions. But still, sometimes some players, they don't understand the situation and they try to fake the referees, to fake the other team. So still, it's possible to punish these players now even more harder than before to destroy the rule. Okay, you know, the rule means that three attacks outside for this player that needs medical care. Some special situation. If the player was in attack and the player needs medical care, of course, and his team continue playing, the player is outside three attacks, but this is the first attack. When one attack starts or finishes, you are coaches, so you understand. Attacks means possession of the ball. One attack can last maybe 1 minute or 10 seconds. I take the ball, I lose the ball immediately. This is one attack, okay, could be. When there is a break time, 15 minutes or 10 minutes break time, and one player was outside during three attacks, immediately in the second time, the three attacks are finished. So the player can play. Also in extra times, overtimes, no more three attacks. The technical delegate is the responsible of the three attacks if the competition have technical delegates, if not the referees are the responsible. Okay. Exceptions. When the defender player, when the opposing player receive yellow or 2 minutes or red card. And then, of course, it's clear, no three attacks outside. Because many people were thinking, oh, in the last minute, and then I can kill Karabatic, and then my team will be the winner. Maybe you can kill Karabatic, we will see. We will see, but probably you receive red or blue card, and then Karabatic can continue playing. So this is not a good idea. Second exception, when the ball is against the face or the head of the goalkeeper. We know that this is a special situation in handball. Sometimes it's not very clear. I hope to take 2 minutes, Armand remind to me at the end of my presentation, to show to you the clear opinion of IHF about two situations happening in the last Women's European Tournament of Sweden. The clear opinion of IHF about this about the ball in the head. Okay, in general, if the ball is in, against the head of the ref or the player, sorry, and the player, the goalkeeper needs medical care, not is not mandatory. The goalkeeper must be outside. Okay. Okay. This is not. Okay. We'll see some video clips. I press a man. Uh-huh. Why is slow motion? No, no. Okay, stop. Okay, I don't know why it's slow motion, but we're first idea. Never, this is clear instruction for the referees. Never stop the match after a goal, for example, because one player is on the floor, destroying a fast throw off, destroying a fast break. Never. First, I remind to you again, high rhythm, high speed of handball. Second, to call doctors later, but later. Never this kind of situations. Normally, well, the player is, it doesn't matter to receive the medical attention 5 seconds later. So this is a negative example for us. First, fast throw off of the yellow team, and then later, when no success or after the goal, we come back and we call doctors. So that's the message. Next clip. I forget this clear. We use this, the next one. We have enough. Now. So again, the third clip, if we possible, if it's possible. Wow. You see, it's the same situation. The Argentinian player, after shooting, score a goal. He's on the floor. But now Denmark tried to make a fast throw off, and the referee said, come on, fast throw off. And 5 seconds later, we come back to take care of the player, you see? But in the meantime, there is a fast throw off Denmark, you see? Goal of Denmark, and the protest of the players, because they don't know the idea of this rule. Sorry, not. High speed, high rim, don't destroy the speed of the match because of one player is on the floor. Of course, immediately the player of Argentina stand up and continue playing. Special situation because two players of the same team are on the floor. And then the advice for the referees is, please be clever. What means be clever? You call the doctors and you must take care if the doctor help to both players. And then both players must go outside 3 attacks or only help to one player and the other player stand up alone. like in this situation, only I think Mikkel Hansen needed medical attention, and then Mikkel was outside three attacks, but the other player of Denmark continued playing. Okay. Next. The computer is tired, eh? Yeah, you are many hard job the last 3 days. I don't know why. Okay, special case for the goalkeeper. The goalkeeper had something like blood. And then the referee told him, please go outside and do something. And blah, blah, blah. This is not the exception. It means that he needs medical care, but this is not the exception when the ball is on the face. So three attacks outside. And he cannot play with blues, as we know. The last one. The ball against the face of the goalkeeper. This is one of the two exceptions. The goalkeeper needs the help of the doctors. Clear. Never red card for this. Never red card for this. As happened in the last Women's European Tournament of Sweden. Okay, then later. But the goalkeeper can continue playing. But in this case, you will see, maybe it was in the first weeks of the rules, and the goalkeeper was sent to the bench for three attacks. Great, great mistake of the referees. Okay. Okay, forget it. Man, the next one. No, this is my photo. Now this. What was the mistake of the referees here? He called, one player was on the floor, of course, instead of to wait 1 or 2 seconds to ask him, do you need help? The referee stopped the match and called the referees immediately. And the same moment, the player stand up. You understand the feeling, you understand the idea? No, wait 1 second, ask to the player, do you need help or not? And normally the player stand up. I don't need help, come on. And now you see, look the player immediately. Okay, 1, 2 seconds. Could be, we are not discussing about 2 minutes. No, this is not the moment. And then the player was outside during three attacks. Next one, Armand. Hollywood action, in my opinion. Too many seconds, and then the referee called the doctors. Maybe we must go to the hospital. This is so important. But now, instead of that, the player is plenty of health, wonderful, and he's thinking only to protest to the referees because, okay, American player puts to me or something. So, this player in attack destroy the fast break, maybe because he was angry. And then, second, he was really unfair because nothing. He didn't need medical attention. So third, should be the decision, sorry, my friend, you are not welcome in our sport. Go. Well, more or less. And the last one. Nice tattoo. Yes. It's too slow motion, I don't know why. So, you see the situation. Okay, could be. Punishment to the defender, the referees didn't decide that, and then we cannot stop the match. We continue, and 5 seconds later, we come back to take care of the player. Normally, this is the idea. Don't break the rhythm of handball. Okay, forget it. Okay, why to stop? You understand? Even with this new rule we discussed later, 7 players and no goalkeeper. Why to stop? Not, no reason. That's the idea of this rule. Okay, I hope to, you understand. Okay, next rule, passive play. wait, what was, why we change this rule? You can read. All the experts thought that the rule is well described, well written in the book. But there was in the past thousands of different, or millions of different criteria. Referee criteria, the referees are the guilty, it's clear. Different criteria. Especially when this is a Champions League match, home and not home play team. Okay, you understand what I mean. And then sometimes 2 passes, sometimes 600 passes, or depends, no time. And then the idea of the top coaches was maximum 6 passes. Because this is a clear objective criteria. And now the criteria is the same for all the referees around the world. No more discussions. Maybe we must work, we must improve what happened before the signal. Okay, in the future, we are working about it. But after the signal, no more discussions. 6 passes. The referees are responsible to count the passes. No more. There is a shoot, block, and the ball comes back to me. This is 1 pass. This is the only special situation. And look this. It's clear message for the referees. Don't close your eyes when the defender team increase the aggressivity. Not be even more strict than in the rest of the match. In that moment, it's not possible holding in any moment, but especially in that moment. Holding, pushing, hitting, kicking, not. And in general, with the experience until now, the defender team are so clever. They train some tactical situation, but not holding, not pushing, normally. So this is a great success. Be strict. I must tell you that in Rio, in Olympic Games, the media of passes in 76 matches were 2.4. 2.4 passes media. Two times seven passes. Two times only seven passes. And five, six times six passes. So it means that, in general, the coaches, the trainers are working with this situation for solutions. Okay, this is after six passes, this is the only special situation. One, two, three, four, five, six. Now we have the ball, and I receive a foul from the defender, free throw, one pass more. Just a little bit punish to the defender, just wait a little instead of to make a foul. Okay? So this is the only. The referees are responsible of the passes. And just a couple of clips. This. Slow motion again. This is Rio. In Rio, there we will. Ah, this is. Sorry for the slow motion, but this is a case with one of the cases in Rio with seven passes. And the referees decided. Forget it, Armand. The next. No, we cannot wait. Next, Armand. Manolo. Okay, in general, I think that this rule is not. It's better now than when we expected. Zero protests until now in the World Championship Junior, Youth, and Olympic Games. No one protest after this rule. It was five, six, or seven passes. So, in general, it was a great success. Okay? Then, while Armand, then, next rule. New rule, last 30 seconds. Really, the last 30 seconds is not a new rule. In the past was 1 minute, last minute. And the top coaches told to us 1 minute is too much time in handball. Sorry, 30 seconds is enough. Good. Second, no matter if one player receives red card plus report, this player cannot play tomorrow, but his team is the winner. This is against the fair play. And then we change. Okay, instead of written report, instead of punish to this player, 7 meters against your team, or against his team. And this is a great success of the handball. And now, every tournament, we see that in the last 30 seconds, all the players and defender team, take care. Because especially when the score is 25-24 or something. And that is, what is the idea of this rule? To avoid that because of unfair or unsportsmanlike action of one player, his team is the winner. To avoid this situation. And to transmit then a positive image of handball. This is the last 30-second rule. in general, until now, no big problem. Two parts so far. First, could be if one player receives a red card in the last 30 seconds. Red card plus 7 meters. Second, this is a little bit not clear for some people. My team is in attack. I have the ball in attack. The referee whistles something against my team, steps, or offensive foul. We know the principle of handball. The ball on the floor. The ball free immediately, free to be played by the defender team. If I do something and the ball is not on the floor, or when the team has the ball, I destroy the fast throw, this is last 30-second rule. Instead of 2 minutes, this is red plus 7 meters. So we are helping the fair play even in that moment. So this is the idea. So just to transmit to the players, hey, attention with the last 30-second rule. Don't destroy a fast break of the other team. Okay? So this is what I explained to you. Even attention with this.
Alors, vous êtes entraîneur et vous êtes responsable hein, également à ce moment-là. Imaginez que l'équipe essaye de faire une contre-attaque. Vous pouvez vous retrouver avec un carton rouge et un 7 mètres. Donc il ne faut pas aller chercher à protester non plus contre l'arbitre. Alors, on va essayer de regarder. Attendez. Le numéro 3, s'il vous plaît. Vidéo numéro 3.
I describe you this situation.
Voilà, donc là c'est un bel exemple. Ça c'était un mois avant les Jeux Olympiques avec l'ancienne règle.
I tell you stop, you stop. When the white player receives the ball after the goalkeeper action, the blue team is playing without goalkeeper. Only stop. Now, okay. No goalkeeper. What means no goalkeeper? To play without no goalkeeper? Big risk, because it's clear chance of goal. No goalkeeper? But it's not the same that if my position is close to the goal, I can score from here, more or less, I can score a goal. That when my position is like yesterday in the match. How many fails? Many fails, a lot. Okay, we discuss later about it. It's not the same, clear chance of goal in 6 meter line or in 35, 34 meter line. But now there is a tactical clear in this case. Goalkeeper stop, the ball coming back to him, and then if, like the white player, I know the situation, no goalkeeper, and then I try really, really to shoot on goal, not to pass the ball, to shoot on goal. And then you destroy this possibility when, in that moment, you see, this is so clear. Not when I'm here with the ball, not. The criteria fixed in Rio de Janeiro Olympics was, if the referees are sure that this is my action and my intention, and you do some kind of foul, this is, must be 7 meters. I'm not talking about red card or 2 minutes, because the most important thing is 7 meters. But this is not in the last 30 seconds on the rules. It can happen in 60 minutes in the match. If I'm playing with 7 players. This is one of the biggest risks of this later new rule. You understand? So that's the... Okay, thanks. Next. No, this not. Next one. Ah, okay. Next. The last one. And we finish. Offensive foul. And the player don't leave free the ball. We are in the last 30 seconds on the match. And then the referee decides red plus 7 meters. Because the fast throw was destroyed. Or not. You see many controversies, the people don't understand exactly the rule. But now, yes, of course, 7 meters. I'm finished. Okay, next. Okay, we have not too much time. No, come on. No, this is more, Herman. Next. Okay, forget it. Next slide. This we finish with this. 3 meters distance. Black back. This clip number. The next one. Clip number 9. No, to the right. This. Last 30 seconds. Foul. Look the defender player. Stop. The defender player is not at 3 meter distance, but it's written in the rules that 3 meter distance means 2 minutes, except if I'm so close, and I'm doing something. I'm active in defense. And then if I destroy or I delay the throw, the fast throw. In this case, okay, I'm not 3 meters, I'm at 1.5 meters, 2 meters distance, but you can execute, you can play. So it could be 2 minutes, could be. But never this is red card plus 7 meters. Because no intention, no destroying, no delaying the throw. But in this case, the referees decided red plus 7 meters. But okay, forget it. Next, blue card. Okay, blue card is not a chain. This is administrative situation. Fortunately, in our sport, not too many situations about blue card. This is for kickboxing, wrestling, or rugby indoor. But sometimes handball and rugby indoor is more or less the same. Okay, we are fighting about it. But just a testing situation. Blue card, please. The IHF rules are so clear. Red and blue are not the same. In European Federation, they are using rules against the only rules in the world. Red card means, okay, some action dangerous for the health of the player, but the player can play tomorrow. Finito. Blue card means real special dangerous action, report of the referees, and the disciplinary commission or something should punish to this player with additional gift, additional matches. This is great difference. But in Europe, they are using red, blue, and wait a minute, I'm writing about you. And all the people in not in Europe, around the world, they are, what is this? I can play tomorrow? You understand? In the past, when the referee saw a red card, nobody knows if the player can play tomorrow or the next week. Today is clear. Red card means no further punishment. Blue card means that probably you cannot play tomorrow. But, okay, this is maybe political discussion. This is not the moment. This is not the moment for me. But just to fix that the clear, what is clear written in the rules. So, okay, forget it. Come on with the last. I discuss later with Manolo and with Patrice. No, forget, no examples. No, we don't need examples. The blue card is too much blues and so. Okay, we can show this. Armand, you. This is what this happened in the situation. Number four. Just this. Look the pivot. Look the pivot and look the face. Now the player. This is a match from Portugal League. I hope you agree with me that this must be directed blue card. Like, first red, then the referees take a meeting together, and then blue, and then 1 or 2 years punishment, more or less, about that. So, fortunately, not too many times in our sport, I hope. Okay, the last slide, Armand. Okay, this situation. You know exactly this rule. We can discuss later if you like too much or too many or we have future. But this is coming from the also clear agreement with the top coaches. Clear agreement with the top coaches in the last 2 years. Until now, we don't need clips. We discuss later with practical demonstration. But until now, I think Manolo will explain us later. There are two different situations, I think, 7 against 6 or 6 against 6 when one player received 2 minutes. Later we discuss, and then I cannot enter in the discussion now, okay, with Manolo and Patrice, yes? So I don't know the... okay, this is nice photos and so many players. So I would like to show to you the last special clips by order. Forget this. This is a special clarification from IHF. Look. It happened, you remember, many of you probably, in the last European Women's European Championship. And the referee decided red card against the player of Netherlands. This is against the rules. You understand? This is against the rules. Never on play, the ball is against the face of the goalkeeper, never can be red card. This is not written in the rules. This is invented. This is the life of the goalkeeper. Yes? You know, some of you. That's the life. So this is what's agreement. And this situation created a great, great polemic around the world. So I want to clarify. Armand, next. You see, 2 days later, different teams, the same action, but different teams. But now the referees, fortunately, didn't decide, sorry, red card, just play on. Never one referee can punish intention of the players. I don't know now your intention. I cannot enter in your mind. So I cannot punish intentions, not just facts. Good. Next. You remember the situation, probably some of you. And this is the only situation written in the rules. 7 meters, and the ball directly against the head of the goalkeeper. That is not in motion. This is the only possibility to show red card, like this. It's clear? I hope. The only possibility. Next. Now, attention. Discussion the referees and immediately decision, red card for the goalkeeper. This is the first time in my last 25 years that I have seen this decision. That is impossible. Impossible. When you train with your goalkeepers, the goalkeeper jumps and foot and head. And hand. Where? In the direction of the ball. And normally there are some crashes. Why there are some crisis collision? Because of the attacker jumps and is inside my house 3.5 meters or more meters. So, wait, stop, wait. So I have so many clips I saw here to the referees in the World Championship. They were not the guilty. To clarify the situation, hundreds of email of clips, sorry, hands and foot, and sometimes make a collision. In my opinion, normally, who is in danger is the goalkeeper. Because many times, this is my foot on the floor, and you are jumping against my foot here. And then, problems. What can I do? Never, okay, there is one exception, some exceptional situation, like this one. And then I finish. Look, for example, the situation, last clip, number 5. When I listen this, oh, I don't need to ask you, what is your opinion? I don't need. So you understand, this is crazy goalkeeper, red, blue, and black. But it's totally different than the first situation. So please, dear referees, no, they are not here. Don't change the rules. Don't change the rules. Because if in a big championship here, for example, we make a crazy decision around the world, we create a great polemic, and then all the people are so nervous. New rules every week, or what about that? So I hope you are coaches, you are clever people, you understand me. Okay. So many thanks, I think, here.
Merci à Ramon Gallego.
Thank you, Ramon. Thank you very much. And hopefully we have enough time left now for Manolo.
Time, and the coach run after. Okay. What do you feel yesterday when you seen the match Brazil France, and you watch the goal empty, and sometimes goal, sometimes out? It's a strange feeling. It's a strange feeling. After the Olympics, I was in the World Championship of Youth and Junior, and after the Olympics, I think that we must research about the real situations that pass in the court. Okay, then this is a short study about the situations that make the teams in the inferiorical numerity in the positional fast attack. Okay, it's not my opinion. It's only numbers. After we can speak about these numbers and that he's mean. Okay. The idea. This study is only when there are the situation for a team with 2 minutes or red card. And when the teams change goalkeeper for player, okay, and play 6 against 6 without goalkeeper in the goal. The idea is look some situations about that the pass in the court. For example, the number and the average of disciplinary penalties. in the same situation in London and in Beijing. The use of these new regulations to play six players and change the goalkeeper for the player. How many shoots appear in a match, in a competition like Olympic Games? What is the result of these situations? When the coach utilize this change, what number of actions, how many actions pass in situation of warming of passive? How many attacks and sub-attacks do the teams when the teams change or when the teams not change? Who is the play system that the teams utilize when attack with six players and without goalkeeper? And last, what is the area of finalization when the teams attack in this situation? The first idea is the characteristic of the study. It's a study when we design a criteria and category. It's an observational methodology. Okay. We work with one software that you know sure is Darfish, and we try to control what happened in the competition. In the Olympic competition in Rio, we have 367 2 minutes and 13 red cards. Total 380 situations of one team play with one player less. This more or less is 33% of the time that the teams play in all the competition. It's a lot of time. The first conclusion is that the number of disciplinary sanctions in Rio increased in comparison of Beijing and London. In Beijing, the teams are 301 exclusions and 13 red cards. In London, 302 exclusions and 8 red cards. And in Rio, 367 and 13 red cards. I know that the intention of the International Handball Federation and his referees is cut the hard actions, but and I let this in the air. Is possible? This is one question. Is possible that after the results to attack with six players and now with one player less, the defense can be more hard? The maximum number of exclusions for a team is from Slovenia, with 13 exclusions in a match. Minimum number for France, Qatar, and Tunisia in these matches, only one exclusion. The maximum number of exclusions in one match is in Brazil-Slovenia, totally 19 exclusions, 6 and 13. And the minimum number of exclusions in a match was in Croatia, Tunisia, and Croatia, Poland, with 5 exclusions. Then, second conclusion. We don't found relation between the number of exclusions, the average of the exclusions, and the final ranking. This is the average of exclusions and red cards from each team. If you see, France is the team with less number of exclusions, 2.9, and Slovenia the maximum. And if you watch the ranking, we can check that we don't have any situation that say if one team has more exclusions, is better or worse classified. Okay. The third conclusion of this study is that the change goalkeeper player in numerical inferiority has been used mainly. Okay? In the 77% of exclusions, the teams make this change, and only in 22% the teams don't make this change goalkeeper player. This is a reference for individual dates, and you can see that in situations 5 against 6 or 6 against 6, you can see that only Egypt, Argentina, and Tunisia has one percentage bigger, with one player less, and that the old teams change mainly the goalkeeper for one player, or for core player, in situations of exclusions. At the moment, for example, I watch Argentina and I watch Egypt, not Tunisia. In this moment, Egypt and Argentina are changing the player. Okay? This is, remember that the Olympics is the first competition after the change of rules. The idea with a comparison with another competitions, Olympic competitions, we don't have dates about the goals in inferiority in London, but we have the reference of actions in Beijing and in Rio. And you can see that the percentage of success in situations of inferiority are better in Rio. The conclusion is that this change, goalkeeper player, is one acceptable risk. Why? Okay, this is a situations. I don't know if you think that is easy score, but yesterday you can see that it's not too much easy. Okay. Shoots direct off goalkeeper, shoots one pass, a lot of these situations. Next, please. But we have also these situations, the same. If you think that these mistakes from the players are strange, you can think about what's been the total number of shoots in one championships. In the Olympics, we count 703 situations with change goalkeeper player. And only 60 times the other team shoots direct to goal. These 60 shoots, only 49 score. Then it's possible that this frequency mean that it's normal that the team with one player less take a risk. Why? Because not too much goal against. This is the percentage, okay? The total of attacks without goalkeeper in inferiority, only 7% of these attacks finally the other team score. What you can see now, that the attack with 5 players is finished. Okay? And these numbers, it's possible that give us more reasons. Different kinds of shoots to empty goal is direct to players. The player take the ball and shoot direct. Shoot one previous pass. Now the coach begin to say, it's better one pass, because I don't have this situation of stress when I recover the ball. The shoots direct from goalkeepers. Okay, until three passes in three times, and 13 shoots direct to goal. Okay. This frequency of total of shoot is 60, 28 direct, one player take the ball and shoot direct, 14 with one pass, 13 with direct shoot of goalkeeper, three times the other team shoot with three passes and two passes with two balls. But only 60. Only 60. Okay? Then, the other situation that we can study is what happened immediately that you lose the ball. What the other team do? The fast quick off, direct fast break, second wave. But we watch that the other team, until the moment, is not training for this. And the team that it's received the attack in inferiority, only three times score with direct fast break, only 10 times score with fast quick off, or only 16 times receive a goal in second wave or fast break in all the championship, in all Olympics. We can understand that the situation of the attack with change goalkeeper player is better because we attack with six players and don't receive too much goals. Okay? Then, for the situations in attack, we speak about three kinds of situation. Positive actions, when the team score, make a score in 2 minutes, achieve 7 meters, 7 meters on your car, okay? This is an example, okay? And we will see that the teams that attack with six players achieve more success. It's normal. It's normal. Then the teams that attack with this change, without this change, like I said, like Argentina, Egypt, and Tunisia, has more situations of negative actions and more situations of neutral actions. Why? Because these teams try that the time pass, okay, without attack. This is the numbers, the result of these situations. You can see in blue with a change goalkeeper player, we have a good results, like goal, like achieve 7 meters. And if you watch the last draw, okay, you can see that in neutral actions, 143% of actions that the teams that play with five players, they won lose the time. Okay? This is levels for teams. I'm later. Okay, I jump. This is the relation that the teams achieve and receive. For example, if you look at Poland is 7 goals received with this situation, and 14 achieve. It's only, repeat, I only numbers, okay? But the situation is I have more success if attack with 6. We don't found some relation between the time and the scoreboard, okay, and the decision of the coaches. The coaches that do this change always do this change. And the coach that in other team that they don't make this change, never make this change. Sometimes the coach, we need train also. And if you have seen some matches, like for example, the first match in Champions League, Veszprém Flensburg, if you remember, there are one action when Veszprém is winning for 1 goal, 15 seconds, okay, to end of the match. And the coach automatically put another player and play without goalkeeper, lose the ball, and I think it's Pascal Mae score. Okay? Because we need training in this situation of stress. Okay? The situation with warning of passive are bigger if you play without without this change, if you play with the change goalkeeper, okay? And this is a number of attacks. The idea is how many times one team attack during the 2 minutes, okay? The numbers, the statistic, say that more or less in each attack, there are in each period of exclusion, we have 2 situations of attack. Okay, but inside this attack, inside each attack, the teams that don't play with the change goalkeeper player has a bigger number of sub attacks. Okay, this is the idea of attacks. More or less, the relation is the same. But if you go to the analysis of the sub attack, the attacks that are in each possession, okay, we can say that the number of sub attacks is different if you control the teams that don't do this change goalkeeper. Okay, systems to play. Usually, it's only in attack. Usually, the teams without goalkeeper that attack 6 against 6 utilize system 3-3. After 3-3 with wins transformation, with first line playmakers or back transformation, or play with 2 pivots fixed. This system utilized, for example, France, Poland, and Croatia play this system. 3 players back, 3 players in the first line, 3 players in the second line. And Qatar, for example, always in this situation attack 1 player less, utilize the wings transformation. Okay? Same for Germany. They play usually when 1 back go to the line of 6 meters. Okay, I don't study the answer of the defense. Okay, but usually you can see that the defense continue the same. Only in Olympics, France change 6-0 to 5-1, but the other teams more or less maintain the same difference, okay? And the last one, the distribution of areas of shoot in the Olympics without change, teams that do the change goalkeeper player or without. This is added, okay? And you can see that the players that do this change goalkeeper player had a better distribution of shoots. Then, 1 minute. This is one check, scientific check in Olympics, but this is the past, okay? The mainly conclusions. The user of the goalkeeper player change may be considered positive, okay? And the punishment reduction is at least questionable, okay? Then Olympics is the past and it's possible some questions that we can see in this World Championship change. For example, utilize the fast break or the quick off against this situation of change. Change in the defensive structures of the teams. More structured actions for the teams in attack. And try to use this change in some moments of the match, with the scoreboard, the time, I don't know. After, I don't know, but this not my opinion. I think we have all one opinion, this is numbers, only numbers, only is the reality, okay? For us, for me also, when you see one shoot against one goal without goalkeeper, or you see one goalkeeper running, it's a strange situation. But sure that your sons don't like the same music that you. Okay? Thank you very much.